Kautik set off towards the village. A ripple of pain surfaced on her face with every step. She kept a firm hold on her stomach. Again and again, her tongue shot out of her mouth, then slipped back in. When it came out, she would screw her eyes tight. When it slipped in, she'd open them again. Resting under a gourami tree, after they had covered a field's distance, she lashed out at herself. "What made you leave home, you bonehead? Best if you'd stayed in." "Why, oh? What happened?" Kautik was in no state to answer. When she got her wits back, she said to Bhima, "Son, run home fast and tell your father I want him here, quick." "Yes," Bhima set off, "but at a leisurely pace." Kautik shouted after him, "You skullhead, running can't you? Other times you got 7 horses straight at me." Bhima remained unaffected. Since he didn't quicken his pace, Kautik rose and said to Rama, "Let's go, son. When has that skullhead ever helped you that he's going to do now?" They hadn't walked more than 2 fields when Kautik needed to be in the shade again. Even as she sank down, she was raising her heels to look towards the village. When she sat down, she said, "Nanya, whose cart is coming this way? Can't make out. Looks empty though, doesn't it?" "Yes." Soon afterwards, Nama said, "Is the brewer's cart here?" "Which brewer? Ganpat?" etc. Sorry, but there's just a little bit later. This woman is in labor, actually, and she is rushing home, and this is how she has her baby. Mahade, the husband to whom she had sent word to come quick, fast, Mahade had just about got into his slippers and was looking around for his cap when the cart touched the plinth. As Kautik stepped out on the veranda, she said, hiding the pain on her face, "At this rate, you're not the one to get water to the dying man in time." "But Bhima just came. Your son, after all, like wheat, like bread." Now, see, "like wheat, like bread" is a very, very crisp translation of the original.